Good evening, dear ladies. Let's bless בעזרת השם שיתגלה משיח צדקנו במהרה בימינו, אמן. הגיע מבשר אליהו נביא, אליהו תשבי, אליהו גלעדי, במהרה ונמשיך בדוד, אליהו נביא זכור לטוב, בעזרת השם. Dear ladies, I'm just reminding you that this week is on Thursday night. It's already Chodesh Kislev b'sha'a tova. It's the beginning of Chodesh Kislev. It's one day of Rosh Chodesh. It's Friday, Rosh Chodesh. But on Thursday night, we can already light a candle for Rosh Chodesh b'si'at
ha'nishma.
Yes.
No.
No, Thursday night, not the whole day of Thursday. It's one day. It's Thursday night is Rosh Chodesh kvar. Erev Rosh Chodesh.
It's 2 days of Rosh Chodesh.
Rosh Chodesh already and Thursday and Friday.
2 days.
It's Friday? Okay, we'll check it again. I'm almost sure. We'll check it again. Doesn't matter. 2 days. Baruch Hashem. 2 days we can celebrate and we can Bezrat Hashem bless. You see, before I started this shiur, which I was afraid of giving this shiur, but Bezrat Hashem, here kvar matchil, Baruch Hashem. Today's shiur, I'll tell you what it is about. It's about the wigs. It's about wigs and about tichel, about mitpachat, kisui rosh. It's the cover of the head. What is the difference between a wig and a mitpachat? Okay? Yes. This is the shiur, but we're going to speak in a minute. Meanwhile, this week's parasha is Parashat Toldot, about Yaakov and Esav, that Rivka gives birth to Yaakov and Esav. So, dear ladies, Hashem gave me the zechut to give a lesson through the Pardes about it. Please go to either TorahAnytime.com or RabbaniTiris.com and please watch a lesson about Parashat Toldot. Another thing, on Rosh Chodesh, on the morning of Rosh Chodesh, we always, Hashem gives me the merit to give you the right combination of the name of Hashem to this month. So the month of Kislev comes from the Pasuk of Parashat Vayechi. It says, Vayar Yoshev Haaretz HaKna'ani, and the Kna'ani that was living in the land saw, because they saw, it's from Parashat Vayechi, they saw all of the Levaya of Yaakov Avinu. When Yaakov Avinu passed away, and all of his children, and from Egypt, the Egyptians came to bury him. So the Kna'ani that was living in Canaan, in the land of Canaan, saw this. So the name of this month, the name of Hashem for this month, comes from this sentence. It's the initials of the words. And there are two names that we just visualize. We don't say that. We don't take the names out of our mouth. When we come to Musaf Shal Rosh Chodesh, after we read from the Torah, we come to the Musaf in the morning. We say, Baruch Ata Hashem, Mekadesh Yisrael, V'Rashei Chodeshim. So when we say, Baruch Ata Hashem, we just visualize in front of our eyes the two names of Hashem. This is the name of Tshuva, and this is the name of Hashem, Yud Kei Vav Kei. It's Vav, the letter Vav, the letter Yud, and then Kuf and Kuf. You remember that Kuf is a hey. I can't write it on the board. And then we have the letter Yud, the letter Aleph, and again Kuf and the Kuf, two hays that come one after the other. This is where we need. And then B'siyata Dishmaya, tubes of prosperity are open for the children of Israel. I would just like to say another thing that we can see. We just finished Chaye Sarah, the life of Sarah. And at the end of the portion of the life of Sarah, it ends with Al Pnei Kol Echav Nafal. You remember the end is about Ishmael. Ishmael is the Arabs, it's the Muslims, dear ladies, and at the end it's about the 12 presidents of Ishmael. When it's finished, it's written Al Pnei Kol Echav Nafal, which means he was spread all over the world, and then he fell from the place that he was. He fell. Wait. Once this is ending, Parashat Chayei Sarah, we come to Parashat Toldot. This is Toldot. The first sentence in Toldot is Ve'ele Toldot Yitzchak. And these are the generations of Yitzchak, the offsprings of Yitzchak, which means what we see now, it's only the step for Mashiach to come out. Immediately, because this is the fulfilling of the prophecy. Once Ishmael is... Once Ishmael spreads all over, dear ladies, he is going to fall. And once he falls, dear ladies, these are the generations, the offsprings of Yitzchak. The children of Israel, Hashem is going to pick them up and raise them up, and everybody will know that they are the firstborn of Hashem, dear ladies. So Yalkut Shimoni says a beautiful thing about it. It says like this in Parashat Chaye Sara, at the end of Parashat Chaye Sara Yalkut Shimoni, it says, and just listen how much it's mamash aktualia, it's what's happening today. עד שלא פשט ידו בבית המקדש, ישכון. כיוון שפשט ידו בבית המקדש, נפל. If Ishmael will not touch Jerusalem, Jerusalem, the temple, Har HaBayit, dear ladies, so Hashem will let him live peacefully. But because he touched בית המקדש, now he's going to fall. It's look, because until he doesn't touch Beit HaMikdash, the holy places for the Jewish people, then, dear ladies, he can live peacefully. But once he touched Beit HaMikdash, then he falls. This is Yalkut Shimoni. Yalkut Shimoni, dear ladies, Chaye Sara. Dear ladies, it says, I'll read it to you from Yalkut Shimoni. I wrote it so you can write it down and see. Is a mamash. We are almost achshav. Ze chol liot kol yom. It's written like this. Rak rega. Amar nafal balan. Amar ishkon el kol yamim shaya Avraham Avinu chay ishkon. Vekevan shemet Avraham Avinu nafal. Ad shelo pashat yado beveit hamikdash. Until he didn't touch the Beit HaMikdash, the holy places of the temple for the children of Israel, Hishkon, he can live peacefully. Kevan shepashat yado beveit HaMikdash, because he touched the holy places for the Jewish people, nafal. This is his fall. Now he's going to fall. This is the end. Dear ladies, we are almost at the end. You know, to die is not bravery. Bravery is to live. Because gvura, we see the Muslims that want to be shahidim, it's not a brave man who brings himself to die and kills others. It's a brave man who lives his life in this world and passes through suffering and raising a family and having the hardship of income of parnasa. This is bravery. Helping his brothers and sisters, his children, his wife, the husband. This is bravery. This needs strength. But this is not an act of bravery to go and kill other people and to be killed. This is worshiping mamash Satan. This is worshiping death, not life. And Hashem, God, is all about life. God brought us to this world in order to live. Hashem brought us to this world to make him a place in this world. This is what all of humanity has to do. So it's not bravery to die. It is bravery to live and to go through the hardships of life. This is bravery. Dear ladies, and having the true emunah and the true confidence, emunah v'pitachon in Hashem, this is bravery. So, dear ladies, I just wanted you to see a little bit of what's happening now, and now we're going to the subject of this lesson. We're going to speak about a sheitel and a tichel, which means a wig, and we're going to speak about mitpachat, okay, a cover of the head, like which looks like something like this. It can be a hat or can be a mitpachat. Please lower all of your, all of the cell phones, please close. And I'm reminding that everything is recorded, so please, and please pay attention to this. Okay, so we are speaking about mitpachat. Yehudit. Vepea. Nochrit. Okay, from the definition is mitpachat, a Jewish mitpachat, and pe'ah, even in Masechet Shabbat, the pe'ah is called nochri. Nochri means goy, a non-Jewish person. This is how it's called. Pe'ah is a wig, a sheitel. Pe'ah is a sheitel. In Hebrew it's called pe'ah nochrit, Which means, dear ladies, that it's a wig that belongs to the non-Jewish people. Nochri in Hebrew means non-Jewish, okay? We're going to speak about it in a minute. First, we'll start. You know, it says, Chazal say, our sages say, Ein adam ששומע לבורא עולם והפסיד. There's no human being that listens, and it doesn't matter if he's a Jewish person or non-Jewish person, that listened to the commandments of Hashem and followed his way, and he lost anything. There's not a man like this, because he or she who listens to Hashem, Hashem gives them back a million times more than they do for Hashem. So we start with this. It says in Tehillim Livriut, Emet. It says in Tehillim chapter 45, Kol kvuda bat melech pnima, memishbetzot zahav levusha. She who has respect and respect to herself and to Hashem and understand that she is a bat melech, a daughter of a king, she has tzniut. Kol kvuda bat melech pnima. She's tzniut, she's modest. 45, yes, Tehillim 45. And then Hashem dresses her up with gold, like the big priest, HaKohen HaGadol beBet HaMikdash. Hashem puts this clothing. It's not physical clothing, it's spiritual clothing. Remember that we are only visitors in this world. When are we tzniut? When are we, us as women are tzniut? When the Siyata Dishmaya, we are shy. We have shyness. When we don't have shy, we have chutzpah, we are fresh. When we are fresh, we are not shy. And then when we're not shy, we don't have tzniut. It goes away. Because once you have tzniut, you are shy. You have this midah, this characteristics of being a shy person. It's a good midah. Because then we won't shout back at people, we'll stop ourselves, we'll be afraid of Hashem, we'll be tzniut also at home, because we understand that Hashem is everywhere and He sees us everywhere. So we have this good characteristics. It's a good characteristic. But the more we take off our clothing, the more we have chutzpah, we don't have any shyness anymore. The more we show, the more we lose this characteristic. So let's continue. It says in Mishlei by Melech Shlomo, King Solomon, Sheker achen vehevel yofi isha yirat Hashem hi titala. It says that the falseness of beauty, falseness of chen,
charm,
the falseness of charm and the vein of beauty, only a woman that has the fear of Hashem, she is going to be praised. So, what happens to a woman when she goes to the other side, to the true world? Everything that she's asked is about tzniut, about modesty. The first thing that she's asked is tzniut, modesty. Why? Because when Hashem created Chava, every part of her that He created, He said, Heyi tznua, be modest. He created her from the rib, because the rib is covered. So He already showed her by parable that He means that she would be modest and chas v'chalila will not cause a sin to other people that look at her. So this is the beginning, but I would like to tell you a story. It says b'midrash rabba icha, it says like this. One of the reasons that the temple was ruined, the two temples were ruined, so listen. It says over here that the women in that time, Vayomer Hashem, and it comes from Yeshayahu, the prophet, chapter 3, verse 16. It says, Vayomer Hashem, Yan ki gavhu bnot Zion, because the daughters of Israel had pride, v'telechna netuyot garon, and they went, you know, with a head up. והבין שפין ברומיהון ומהלכין בקסות רוח, and their walk was not even modestly, ותנך לנטויות גרון, וכשהייתה אחת מהן לובשת תכשיטיה את המתה מכאן ומכאן. They put their jewelry, moved them so everybody can see that they have jewelry on them. They were dressed not modestly, and they would put too much makeup on the face to attract people to look at them. B'siyata d'shmaya, the way that they walked is with their legs, so they will attract attention. With the way they walk, So it says that because of this, this is one of the things that Hashem says, because of the non-modesty of the Bnot Israel, the daughters of the king, the children of Israel, the women of the children of Israel, this was one of the severe things that the first temple was ruined. There's another thing. We go to Rabbi Chaim Vital. He lived over here. Rabbi Chaim Vital was, Zchutot Hagen Elenu, was the student of Arizal and also of Rabbi Moshe Cordovero, שכתב את דומר דבורה, זכותם תגן עלינו. So he lived, he was born in Italy. He lived in Sfat. And then he went to Damascus. Damascus is the capital city of Syria. And he over there he passed away in the 17th century, in 1620 approximately, he passed away. So dear ladies, there's a big story about him. And I'm going to open Sefer HaChezionot. He wrote this book that is called Sefer HaChezionot about things that happened to him. At that era, at that time, a lot of people, also in Poland, in every place, Hashem brought, it's like a dibuk. It's like a soul that comes into a person while he's alive, that goes into and controls his body. And then what happens is this person does not even move his lips, but that soul is speaking through him, okay. Occupies his body and speaking through him. And I want you to hear. Yes. זה כמו דיבוק, אבל זה לא בדיוק דיבוק. It's like a soul occupying your body. So it says like this. That בשנת שין סמך תת, עירה דבר גדול בדמשק. There was a big thing that happened in Damascus. ולא אכתוב פה רק הנוגע לי. This is what Rabbi Chaim Vital says. I'm not going to write here. Only that things that touches me, are concerned about me. It says it's the evening of the 29th of Tammuz. And the daughter of Rafael Anav, the rabbi, Rafael Anav, she had it was Shabbat evening, it was Kiddush, they were all sitting, there was fish on the table. And V'i Laila, Yalel Shabbat, V'rosh Chodesh Av, Achar Adlakat Ner Shabbat. They were sitting and eating fish, and she ate from the fish, and at that moment she fell from the chair. She fell from the chair and she was like dead. She was on the floor. The daughter of Rafael Anav, the rabbi, was on the floor like she was dead. And then there was a voice coming out of her. Kol echad yotze mepia. Rafael, he calls the rabbi. Bolekan, he calls him. He says, come over here. Vayishal mi ata. And the rabbi is asking, who are you? Vayomer ani hu chacham piso. I am the chacham piso. ולמה לא הדלקתם זולת שני נרות כמנהג? Why did you only light two candles as it's as for Shabbat? והיה לכם להדליק נרות הרבה לכבוד המלאכים. You should have lit a lot of candles for all of the angels. ונשמות הצדיקים and the tzaddikim שבאים ממי ללוותני לשמור אותי. He says, I came now and a lot of angels and a lot of tzaddikim came with me. And you should have lit candles for all of them. But Rav Rafael Anav did not see it. He didn't see it. The voice is speaking. ולכן הכינו להם כיסאות. He says, prepare chairs for all of the tzaddikim so they can sit. כי הם שישה נשמות. There are six souls of tzaddikim that came with me. He says, prepare six chairs for them so they can sit. ויאמר, I am not the same, he says. Ani hineni kishar aruchot. I'm not the same like all of the spirits. Because there are spirits that don't have, after they sinned in this world, they don't have rest. So, and they have destructive angels that go after them and cause them a lot of suffering because the soul is the one that feels the suffering. So in order to run away from those angels, they try to go into la'alenu human beings. And to possess their body, because then the angels cannot touch them once they are inside a human being. But he says, I'm not like them. Lo bati ki malchet kal shenishar li letaken. I came because I have one small sin that I have to fix, he says. וגם להיות שליח לכם. And I'm your שליח, he says, להשיבכם בתשובה מרוב העבירות שבכם. To make you do תשובה from all of the sins that you have.
But he was a rabbi himself. And
yes, he had one small sin. You see, anything that we do counts. anything that we do, and we're going to pay for this, either a good payment or not so such good payment. But everything that we do counts. Everything, dear ladies. והנה יש חף א' יום שיצאתי מגן עדן, דרך נערי גן עדן. He says, I went out of paradise, I was in paradise, I went through the rivers of paradise, ובאתי תחת הקרקע, I went under the earth, עד נערות דמשק, until the rivers of דמשק, ושם נכנסתי בדג אחד, and I went, and Hashem put me inside a fish, וצד אותי הצייד, and the fisherman took me, והולכני למכור לרחוב היהודים. And he brought the fish to the street of the Jewish people. בערב שבת אחר המנחה, ונזדמן שם רשע, there was a wicked person that wanted to buy me, but then הרב רפאל ענב, the rabbi רפאל ענב ראה, and he took that fish. And he was supposed to take the fish. So he says, ואני הייתי בראש הדק, and I was in the head of the fish. ואכלתני ביתו, and your daughter, he says to Raphael Anav, to the rabbi Raphael Anav, he says, your daughter ate me, ונכנסתי בה ולא הזקתי הכלל. And I went into her, but I didn't hurt her. I didn't do any damage to her. Because lo alenu, when there's a soul that is not so good, it damages the person. Yeah, כי אני אינני כשאר הרוחות. I'm not like the other spirits. ולא נתנו לי רשות להתגלות ולדבר עד הטיים. 21 days already, but they didn't allow me to speak until now, which is ראש חודש אב, he says. כי הוא שבת וראש חודש, because it's שבת and ראש חודש. ולמאוד אני עצב שלא זכיתי לעלות זה היום הקודש למקומי בגן עדן. I'm so sad that this is a very big day and I'm not in my own place in paradise, he says. טוב. He says, please call me to call Rabbi Chaim Vital Zchutot Hagen Elenu and tell him to come. So the rabbi went, dear ladies, to call him. Rabbi Rafael Anav went to call him and Rabbi Chaim Vital came. As ba Rafael and Rabbi Yaakov yagidu li kol haniskar. This is what he says in first person. So Rabbi Chaim Vital says that they called him. Ve'alachti sham, and I went over there. Uvi kan si bapetach, and I went when I was in the entrance. Amar li, this voice told me, shalosh pe'amim, three times, shalosh pe'amim, baruch haba, baruch haba, baruch haba, welcome, welcome, welcome. Venitkarafti ela ne'ara, and I came near the daughter of Rabbi Rafael Anav. Ve'ine masbe al paneha, v'ike peger met. He says, I looked at her face, she looks like a dead person. ואומר לי, and this voice that is inside of this soul, מניין אתה מכיר אותי? Where do you know me for? ויאמר, וכי אין אתה הרב חיים המקובל? Aren't you רבי חיים ויטל המקובל, the מקובל? אמרתי לו, מי אתה? ויאמר, אני החכם פיסו. I am the wise man פיסו. He was a big rabbi. והפצרתי בו להודיענו שמו. So he tells him his name. And he says, I passed away from this world 35 years ago, 35 שנה. ועליתי למקומי בגן עדן, and I went to my place in paradise. וישבתי שם עד עתה, and I was there until now. ונשאר לי לתקן עניין אחד קטן. And I have only one small thing to fix. What would we say? One small thing to fix. ובאתי עתה לתקנו, and now I came to fix it. ולכן אוי לו, he says. ולכן אוי לו, אוי to this person, למי שאינו נזהר בעולם הזה אפילו מחטא קטן. אוי לו to the person that isn't careful even with a small sin. כדי שלא יבוא לידי זה מה שאני עובר, he says. That he won't have to go through what I am going through, he says. And this is a tzaddik that had only one small sin. That had to go from paradise down back to earth, under the ground, through the rivers of Gan Eden, which means the ones that are not so tzaddikim, not so righteous, what they passed through. Tov, and he says, ונראה לי, he says, and Rabbi Chaim Vital says, כי היה חטאו על שחטית הרבים במניעת לימוד דרכי התשובה. Which means he says, somebody told me, about doing tshuva, about a thing that I didn't think that was so important. So I did this with my hand. Like it's not so important. And because of this, a lot of people that saw this, instead of doing tshuva and doing it, did not do it. So pay attention. It's like doing a face about another person and causing lashon hara to a lot of people that look at you and understand that this person, lo mashum yuchad. So just pay attention what happens. This is the only thing that he did. So let's continue. So again, Rabbi Chaim Vital says that Achet shlo ya bitul ha-tshuva, and he came to fix it. And by telling Rabbi Chaim Vital to, Bezat Hashem, to do tshuva to all the women and men in Damascus, the capital of Syria. Amarti lo, Rabbi Chaim Vital tells him, Amarti lo, v'rei anshei Damascus enam chafetzim bedroshotai. But the people of Damascus, they have rabbis, they don't want to hear me. They say that what I say is not important enough. They don't want to hear me. Amar li, kvar kol ze galui lifnei ha-makom baruch hu. Hashem already knows this, he says. Amar tim, ken nekabetz talmidei chachamim bilvad. I will take only, scholars in Torah. Maybe I'll teach them. Amar li tovu, okay, take only the scholars. Amarti, eni yode et mi ekabetz, I don't know who to call. Amar li, he told me, lo tavi lefanai shum chacham, he says, from these and these students, ela talmidei chachamim sfaradim, but only bring me Sfaradic scholars. And except for these and these people. Now, you have to understand, because I'm not giving you the whole story. This neshama saw big rabbis next to her, and this soul told them, this is your sin, you do this, this is what your daughter does, this is what your wife does, this is what your son does, mamash, all of their sins. So please close the cells. So he tells him, this one I don't want to see. He mentions names, he said, this rabbi I don't want to see, I don't want to see his face. And he says, Amarti elech v'etpelel. I said, I'm going, first of all, to daven, and then I'll come back. And he says this, dear women.
Who is going to daven?
Sorry, he went to pray. Mincha or Arvit, he went to pray. The Rabbi Chaim Vital, Ken. He says, I cannot speak to you anymore now. I have to go and play and pray. And now he tells him this. Now, please pay attention what he tells him. When he comes back, he says, Oy lachem chachmei zman hazeh. Oy to all of the rabbis and the rabbitsons and all of the people that give Torah in this generation. And it's true to every generation. Sheinchem mashivim et ha'am betshuva. That you don't cause the children of Israel to do tshuva. It says, "Sof davar, oy lachem chachamei ador sheyesh lachem gaava vabuz, that you have pride, ve'enchem mashgichim al kvod hakadosh baruch hu la'ashiv ha'am b'tshuva, ve'atem gormin ra'a gdola ba'olam." That instead of thinking about the honor and pride of Hashem, you think about your pride. Instead of thinking of the pride of Hashem, and you prevent people of doing tshuva, he says. And this causes sins to the majority. Because the rabbis are the example of the community. Rabbis and rabbitson are the examples of the community. And it says that gam neshotechem, that your women, holchot chatzufot, they go fresh, they are dressed fresh, bilvushim v'tachshitim shel gnai, with jewelry and clothing that are not fit for a Jewish woman to wear, because it says that they show the breasts. What do they mean, show the breast? That they dress up with very tight clothing, that the breast is shown from it, they say. כתוב ככה, ודדיהן מגולות וממלין חיקיהן בבגדים להראות שדדיהן גדולות. That people can see that they have big breasts. ומוליכות אלו, and they take panties it's called, גרביונים. Panties, but very thin panties that you can see your leg.
איך?
Pantyhose that are very thin, that you can see the legs through it. dear ladies. להראות גופם in order to show their body. ומסימין מיני פסמים וריחניים, and they put too much. Dear ladies, listen, I had to read this to you because בזכות נשים קצת קניות נגלו עם ישראל במצרים וזכותן עתידין לגאל. Because of righteous women, the children of Israel were saved from Egypt, and because of us righteous people, women, that we are going to be saved. And they put too much perfume לגרות יצר הרע באנשים in order to attract men. וכל זה מוליכים בשווקים וברחובות להראות העמים את יפים. And all of this they do not in their house, but outside, in order that all of the men will know them, will see them, will attract them, even if they don't do anything with them. But just to track attention. Okay. This is what the Spirit says to Rabbi Chaim Vital. I would like to tell you. It says. I would like to tell you about Eshet Abba Chilkiah, the wife of Abba Chilkiah. The wise men, the sages saw her, that she goes out to her husband. She has jewelry, she looks beautiful, she's dressed nice, and she walks out to her husband in order to greet him. So the sages told him, the Chachamim said, tell me, Rabbi, why does she do this? He says, because she doesn't want me to look at any other woman. So she dresses up nicely at home in order that my attraction will be only to her. My eyes will be only to her. Okay, I'm just building it, and then we'll see where we're going together. So it says in Shulchan Aruch, Ibn Ezer, dear ladies, Ilchot Ishut, it says like this, Chaf Aleph, צריך אדם להתרחק מאנשים. A man should stay away from women. מאוד מאוד, very much. מה זה נשים? אתם יודעים מה זה, what is the initials of נשים? What did I do with that? I want to show you. נשים, נשים is שומר, נפשו, ירחק מהם. שומר, נפשו, ירחק מהם. He who is afraid for his soul should stay away from women. Just his wife and his mother, but not be attached to other women. This is the initials of women, dear ladies. ברוכה הבאה, נשמה. This is the initials. So it says that Asulo, he is not allowed to do a sign with his hand to women, a man. This is Shulchan Aruch. It's not me. It's everything Shulchan Aruch. Rabbi Yosef Karas, Fototot Agen Elenu, with the Rama that agrees with him, with everything that is here. So it's for Sephardic, Ashkenazic, Yemenite, for Klal Yisrael. צריך אדם להתרחק מאנשים מאוד מאוד, ואסור לקרוץ בידיו או ברגליו, ולרמוז בעיניו לאחד מהעריות. And he's not allowed to make any sign for any woman that he's not allowed to look at them. ואסור לשחוק עמה ולהקל ראש כנגדיו, which means to make jokes and to speak, because then, חס ושלום, you can come to thoughts that are not in their place, dear ladies. And what's the problem? The problem is that when you are intimate with your husband, after the women came from the mikveh, and she's intimate every time with her husband, the time that they're intimate, any time Hashem can give a righteous soul to them. So this is called like they are in the holiest of holiest, like they are in Beit HaMikdash, where only once a year the high priest goes into. Once a year he goes into the holiest of holiest, which is on Yom Kippur, in order to atone for the children of Israel. So when a husband is intimate with his wife, she came from the mikveh, this is a time of holiest of holiest. And when he has an image of another woman, it's like he brought idolship into the Beit HaMikdash. At kedei kach. And then the soul comes from a different place. So if we want a righteous soul, we have to clean our minds from everybody. We have to keep our eyes. That the eyes will be holy. And he's not allowed to joke with her and speak around, or להביט, or look at her beauty, אפילו להריח בבשמים שעליה אסור, even the perfumes, in order that he won't be attracted to her. טוב, dear ladies, I'm not giving you all of it, just a piece of it. And it's written, "Lo telechna bnot Israel pruot rosh bashuk." The children of Israel are not allowed, the daughters of Israel are not allowed to go with a head not covered. And achat pnuya v'achat eshet ish, which means in the past, even the ones that were not married, from the age of 12, they covered their head. Even the ones that were not married, from the age of mitzvot, they covered their head. And if she doesn't cover her hair, which is okay today, except for married women, divorced or widows, that they have to cover their hair. But if she doesn't cover her hair, but when she davens, it says, even the Rambam says, she needs to cover her hair. When she davens to Hashem, it's good to cover the hair. I know today most of them do not, but then today it says that all the halachot says that today a married woman, a divorced, and a widow have to cover their head. So let's continue.
Women have obligation to cover their hair while we pray, like men have to come.
Yes, so it says, "Ken." That's why it's written b'Shulchan Aruch. It's written because when you daven to Hashem, you need to cover your head.
Yeah.
You need to cover.
The wig have to cover it.
Wait, Shalom. I'll explain about the wig. Don't worry. We're coming to this. I'll explain exactly what the rabbi says about it. Everything. What I'm giving you today is everything Bezat Hashem. From the books, I brought books. It's very heavy to carry it with me because I wanted to show you. ומפני מה איש יוצא ראשו מגולה והאישה ראשה מכוסה? It's בראשית רבה, dear ladies, פרק י' זין. It's written, why does a man go with his head without a cover, only a kippah, and the אישה ראשה מכוסה, and the woman has to cover her head? אמר להן לאחד שעבר ברעב ומתבייש בבני אדם לפיכך יוצאת בראשה מכוסה. Because she caused the sin of death in the world, because she ate first and then she gave Adam Arishon. That's why it's like out of shame of what she did. And usually the custom is when there's a dead person, you cover your head. When you sit Shiva, you cover your head. So this is also a custom behalachot by the Jewish laws. So that's why when you get married, you need to cover your head. But you know, it says, dear ladies, that Chava, at the beginning when Hashem introduced her, gave her to Adam, He braided her hair, tzamtzamot, and brought her to Adam. Her head wasn't covered. But after we went through the sin, then the hair was covered. Now, dear ladies, we can see in the Torah two places that speak about covering your head. One is Parashat Neso, when Hashem says that if there's a problem that a man is jealous of his wife, and he thinks that she cheated on him with another man. So he takes her to the priest. And the priest over there takes water and afar, dear ladies, and dirt. And puts them together and puts an amulet with the name of Hashem and gives it to drink. But what does he do first? It says that he takes out the cover of her head. Vepara et rosha. The second place we see it is in Parashat Korach. You remember the disagreement of Korach? And On Ben Pelet was one of the people that joined Korach with a disagreement because he didn't feel comfortable. He was his neighbor, yes, and he joined him. And then his wife tells him, why do you join the disagreement? If Moshe Rabbeinu is the rabbi, you are the student. If Korach is the rabbi, you are the student. It doesn't matter to you. Don't join them. But said, I gave my word to Korach that I'm going to come with him. So what did she do? She put him in the tent. She gave him alcohol to drink. He was drunk totally. And when they came to call him, she went out without the cover on her head. And they were very righteous. They knew that they're not allowed to look at her once she's without the cover. So they went away. And meanwhile, what happened is that Korach and all of the people with him went into the ground and the fire took them with her. And she saved her husband. So this is the cover on the head. We can see it several places. But what does Rivka do? Rivka is not married yet. But when she sees Yitzchak, and we just saw it, she covers her head with a tzeif, mitpachat. Okay, she covers her head. Tamar. And from her came Yaakov Avinu. And Tamar, and from him the whole 12 tribes, which means that because of these deeds, that she has righteous children. We look at Tamar. Tamar is the daughter-in-law of Yehuda. And two of her husbands, two of the children of Yehuda were married to her and they died. And Tamar, when she goes to her father-in-law, she goes covered. She covers her hair. And from her came David HaMelech, King David, Mashiach. Okay, love you. And let's continue. It says, במסכת יומא בגמרא, בתלמוד בבלי and also בתלמוד ירושלמי, about Kimchit. Kimchit had 7 boys. All of them were high priests. She had the zchut to see all of them high priests. And why? The sages asked her, why, how did you have this zchut to have such 7 boys high priests? So she said, because I covered my head with a mitpachat all the time, dear ladies.
Even the walls.
Yes, even the walls of my house did not see my hair. Which means she was modest at home like she was modest outside, dear ladies. Ze Kimchit. Her name was Kimchit, dear ladies.
I just wanted to ask you a question.
Write the questions. Let me finish and then תרשמי לך את השאלה ואז אני אענה לכם. Okay, let's continue. איפה זה? Remind me also to open Yalkut Yosef, that I won't forget. B'siyata Dishmaya. So, dear ladies, there's a book that was just now was spread out in Israel, and it's called The Last Test, Anisayon Acharon, The Last Test. Everything that you wanted to know and didn't have the courage to ask, or if you didn't think about asking, this is the time to get answers over things that you didn't know. So, dear ladies, we know that tzniut is the oraita. Being tzniut is from the Torah. Because atzna lechet im elokecha. Be modest with your God. Which means tzniut is the oraita. We know that Hashem said the woman has to be tzniut. We know it from Sarah Imenu that when the angels came, she did not go out of the tent. She was the one that taking care of the women and Avraham Avinu took care of the men. From here we know that this is tzniut, that she didn't mingle around with all of the men, dear ladies. And it says that all כתוב כך שכמעט כל עונשה in the book of Chesed לאלפים it's written שכמעט כל עונשה ושכרה של האישה בעולם הזה ובעולם הבא הם ענייני צניעות. That the reward and the punishment for a woman in this world and in the true world is all about צניעות, all about modesty. Just imagine, all about modesty, dear ladies. And then it says שחומרה אחת בצניעות. And this is by the Rahag Shlomo Zalman Oirbach, זכותות הגן עלינו. He says, שחומרה אחת בצניעות שקולה ליותר מ-100 חומרות בכל התורה כולה. That one הקפדה that we do in צניעות is like 100 הקפדות in all of the things and all the commandments of the Torah. One הקפדה of צניעות. And why? Because I already told you, נשים יקרות, בסייעתא דשמיא, that we had a lesson about it. That tzniut, without a vav, tzadik is 90, nun is 50, yud is 10, ayin is 70, and taf is 400. How much is it together? 620. Keter, crown, exact half is 20, taf is 400, resh is 200. Which means, when is a wife a keter, a crown for her husband, a teret rosho, when she's tzniut. It's like the woman fulfilled all of the 620 commandments that are in the Torah. There are 613 commands in the Oraita, and 7 commandments, the Rabbanan, together, from our sages, together it's 620. So just by being tzniut, it's like we fulfilled the whole Torah.
But does he miss the vav?
Yes, I'll touch the vav in a minute. We have 626 with the vav. And with the vav, it's 12 times the name of Hashem, Yud Kei Vav Kei, and the name, dear ladies, of Shaddai, Shomer Daltot Israel, which means this is protection. But our tzniut is our protection. It's like a whole choma is around us. It's not only around us, it's around Klal Yisrael. How did the women from Egypt, the Jewish women, help their husbands? They didn't have wigs then. All of them had mitpachat, all of the women. And they weren't Ashkenazi or Sephardic or Yemenite. All of them were the same. Jewish women, righteous Jewish women. So in order that we will bring Mashiach, we need to go back to be like those women, dear ladies. And to go back to the minhagim that we had then, to the custom that we had them. And go back to those halachot. It's written that Arak, Aaron Rateb, Baal Shomer Emunim, the one that wrote Shomer Emunim, Zchutot Hagen Aleinu, it's written about him, he says, a woman, Isha Sholechet Hayom B'Tzniut, that goes today in Tzniut, Umitkavenet L'Shem Shamayim, and does that for the sake of heaven, Magina Al Chelek Mikol Ador Hazeh. She's not only protecting herself, she protects part of the whole generation. Not only herself. Dear ladies, it's written by the Chazon Ish, Zchutot Hagen Aleinu. Godel Yirat Shamayim Shel Aisha. The amount of the fear of Hashem of a woman, Nikar Bekisui Rosha, is known by the way she covers her head. Kemidak Dikduka Bekisui Rosh Kenirata. The way she covers her head and the way she keeps her hair inside, dear ladies, this is how she fears from Hashem. Because she understands that there's somebody that's watching her. She cannot do whatever she wants. You see, the Yetzer Hara, the evil inclination, wants us to say, well, don't you want to look beautiful? Yes, I want to look beautiful in the eyes of Hashem and in the eyes of my husband. You understand? But we'll come to it. Dear ladies, it's written like this: Shepea nochrit haniret kesear asura biisur muchlat lechol adeot. That a wig, a shetel, that is with real hair, is forbidden for all the opinions. Afilu mi synthetic, even if it's synthetic. גדולי התורה והחסידות במכתבן משנה תפשין למד היי. The big rabbis and scholars from the Torah and Chassidush, they wrote in a letter from the year תפשין למד היי, Dear ladies, וכל גדולי הדור, הגרשז אורבך, הגרבץ אבא שאול, הגרי צדקה, הגרי של ישיב, the rabbi אל ישיב, הגרב שנייברג, זכר צדיקים לברכה, and I'll give you all of the names in a minute. It says, זכר צדיקים לברכה, then הגר שטיינמן, הגר וזנר, הגר קרליץ, הגר זילברשטיין, with a letter that they wrote in the year of תפשין מם זין, all of them say that this is forbidden totally. I would like to tell you another thing. They also say that most of the shetels, most of the wigs have hair that come from India, from Hodu, that before they give the hair, this is hair of women that passed, that died, before they give the hair, they take it to Avodah Zarah, they take it to idolship. Over there they do what they do and they bless, and then they give it out to make wigs from it. And it says in the book that today nobody truly knows where the hair comes. Even if you think that it comes from Europe, it's still mixed with the hair that comes from India. And there's nobody can definitely say that this is a hair that doesn't come from it. But anyway, they say that wigs that come from real hair are forbidden totally, and even synthetic hair. But we'll go through everything. And I would like to remind you that I also had a wig. Yeah. I have lessons with a wig. Yes. And I would like to remind you that I gave, I think, one of the lessons I told you about it, but I also had a wig, and I went with a wig to give lessons and to, of course, to weddings or things, you know, lechaim. And I remember when I took off my wig and started coming with a techel in mitpachat, I remember the first time, I have to tell you, I was very nervous. I was all sweating before I gave even the lesson. From I knew what people will tell me when they'll see me. And why did I take off the wig? Because there was a woman in one of the lessons that I gave in a synagogue in Queens. And one of the women after the lecture, after the Torah lesson, she came to me and she said, you know, the whole lesson I was looking at you. And I saw how your hair goes from side to side and it's very nice, it's very interesting just to look at you. And I said to myself, wow, I never thought about it like this. It didn't even occur to me. Because I was giving a lesson, I didn't think about the hair going from side to side. I didn't think about it. So I went back home and I said, I didn't want, first of all, to think about it. Ah, what nonsense. I didn't want to think about it. That's what was in my head. But then at night when I was sitting in my bed and I said, Hashem, you didn't, why would she come and tell me such a thing? You know, it was in my mind. Why did you send her to tell me this? So I said to myself, if she looks at me like this, so a man who looks at me, he also sees this. And then he says to her, it attracts, because a hair, this is the like the crown of a woman, the hair. It attracts the attention of people around her.
She came to see if you had the pe'ah or not?
No, wait, I'll tell you a thing, wait. I'll tell you a thing about this, okay? So I told myself, I understand that you want me to take off the wig totally. I said, Hashem, give me the strength, because I don't want to see, when we walk in the street, I had a student that went to Connecticut, that moved to a new house in Connecticut, but she used to come to Brooklyn to my lessons. Yeah. And she used to tell me, you know, she goes with a tichon, with mitpachat. And she used to tell me when I drive with my husband, when he drives and I see all the wigs and the women, the way they dress like they come from Paris, I have to close his eyes, but I cannot close his eyes because he's driving, because I look like shmates, because I dress with white things, because this is what Hashem wants me to do. And I go with mitpachat and he sees all these women walking in the street. And I say to myself, well, how can I protect myself? And I said, you don't have to, Hashem will see that Bezot Hashem, his eyes will be only for you because you're doing what Hashem, you see, remember this was the first thing that said, En Adam Sheshomea LaBorei Olam V'Hafsid, because you're doing the will of Hashem, Hashem won't let you lose anything. Because you're doing his will, so he will give you Chen V'Chesed. He will give you the beauty. Once you are beautiful in the eyes of Hashem, everybody will think that you are beautiful. Because the soul, your soul will be outside. Not the hair will be outside, the soul will be outside. Not the clothing that is, you saw what Rabbi Chaim Vital said, that this soul said. Because today, you know, I had there was one Hasidish boy that came to me on Shabbat. And he told me, you know, you should tell your Talmidot that they shouldn't go with the skirts, the pencil skirts. You know, the ones that are tight, that you can see the body. And there was a father that came and told me this. He says, I don't understand. These are righteous women. And they go with such tight skirts. Dear ladies, we just read about the temple that was ruined because of this. We just read by Rabbi Chaim Vital that it was ruined. That he told him to speak to the women of Damascus in order that they will do tshuva and dress differently. Because this is the beauty of the children of Israel, of not Israel. Why? Because once I go like this in the street, listen very carefully, all the men that look at me, dear ladies, all of their thoughts, their avirot, their sins that were caused because of me, I have half of it. Without doing anything, just walking in the street. This is what happens in the other side, in the true world. Half of it, la'alenu, we take. We don't need this. We have enough of our own. We don't need sins of other people. We do it enough. We are just flesh and blood. כתוב שלא יהיה צדיק שיעשה טוב בארץ ולא יחטא. There's no righteous person that does even this. חכם. חכם פיסו, even him. There's no righteous person that does good and won't do a sin. So we don't need sins of others. But once, and you have to know, we'll speak in a minute. But once we do this, we don't even pay attention to this. And don't worry about getting married. Because the marriage is from Hashem. Zivug is from Hashem. It's not from us. Hashem brings us the zivug. Sometimes we miss the zivug because we have too much pride and we are too much bererim, borer, choosers. Like we don't want this, this is too tall, this is too small, this is like, we don't look at the characteristics of the man that is sitting next to us, in front of us when we go to a date with him. We don't search for Yirat Shamayim, for the fear of Hashem, because only a man or a woman that have the fear of Hashem, we sleep with the characteristics of the person, not with the external beauty, but with the characteristics of a person. This is what we live through the whole life. Not with the money, because even if we don't have money together, not enough money, but when we have good characteristics, we can manage together. We are a team. We are as one. We're like one flesh. There's no two human beings that are separated in that bed, but one flesh is there. Really, Adam. So let's continue.
So what about women that change their ways?
So, and the Berzot Matirshev, we'll write the questions and we'll answer everything. Nashim Yekarot. There's a woman that is telling a story. I have to tell you this. It says, Ishachat mesaperet. Yom echad nasati ba'autobus. This is in Israel. She was driving, she was in the bus. Umachara shbuzuk chilonim. Behind me, there was a couple that was not observant. Ma vikuchim shebeneim. She heard them. They had vikuchim, discussion between both of them. Evanti shem yetzu karegem meize seminar liyadut o arza. I understood that they went to a seminar or a Torah lesson, and this is why they have a disagreement among them. I was very curious, she said. Lishmo ma'ay medabrim, what they are saying. Pitom ha'isha omeret lebala. Suddenly this woman says to her husband, Tere et ha'charedit hazot. Look at this observant woman. Tere, hi niret yoter yafa im ha'peah shela. She looks more beautiful with her wig. With a sheitel, Bala Marla Tzodeket. You're right. Because I think what's happened over here that her husband told her to, maybe you should put a kisui rosh. So her husband says, you're right. Nachon, aval lo kol ha-charediyot samot kacha. Not all of the observant women put a wig, a sheitel. He says, Yesh kele shebe'emet mechasot et ha-sa'ar shelem. There are those who really cover their hair. So look what this woman said. Ba'oto rega, at that moment, this is her testimony, where she's telling what she heard. Ba'oto rega irgashti kol kach ra im atzmi. She says, I felt so bad with myself. Ratziti she'adama tivla oti. I wanted that the ground will open and I will be inside. Itbayashti, I was ashamed. Ani kol kach mashkia b'yiddishkeit. I do as much as I can, you know, to daven, to read tehillim, to do tzedakah. Ani zot she'eseh chilul Hashem. I am doing chilul Hashem because they look at me and they say, so why should I cover myself? Because look at her, how she's covering her head. It's not a cover. Echlafti lemitpachat. And she changed and started putting a mitpachat, a tichel. Ani lo achik yehudim ma'kadosh baruch hu. I will not make Jewish people go away from Hashem. Now, dear ladies, in this book, they gathered also all of the Jewish commandments that a woman doesn't do when she puts a sheitel, a wig. First of all, it's like bepara et rosh ha'isha. Why? Because when the Kohen Gadol came and took off the cover from the woman, so she, then you can see her hair. The wigs today is just like her own hair. It doesn't matter.
No,
if she goes, even beautiful, yes. This is, wait, I'm give you all the rabbis, wait, please listen. Please, I'm doing this because if we will change ourselves, b'siyata d'ishma, you know how many women, Ashkenazi women and Sephardic women in Israel took off the wigs and started putting a mitpachat. This is kiddush shem shamayim. In Israel, hamon osot etze. A lot of women do it. So it says, "Bepara et rosh ha'isha." So this is the first, it's from Chumash Bamidbar, chapter 5, verse 18. And then, "Bechukoteim lo telechu." You should not go in their ways, in the ways of the goyim, of the non-Jewish. Why? Because pe'al, dear ladies, is a wig in Hebrew, and it's called pe'an ochrit. This is how they call peah in Hebrew, peah nochrit. Nochri means non-Jewish person. Do you understand? But I would like to show you. What did I tell you now? That if we are tzniut, we have the crown. We are the crown of Hashem. Hashem puts us as a crown. Nachon? But if we go with peah nochrit, dear ladies, then instead of a crown, we have karet. You remember that we went through karet? Do you see karet? Karet? Look, dear ladies. If we go, look, please. I know it's not easy. I'm just giving you everything that Hashem gave me to give you. And if you change the letters, it's keter. It's a crown.
O karet o keter.
Look, dear ladies, just look at it. And then look, she who goes, it comes, you know, you remember that we said that the whole Torah is by the letters, we are built from letters. So if you look again at it, what the letters that are left over, you see is Yud, the letter Vav, and the letter Nun. It's Yavan, Greek, it's Noi, beauty, external beauty. Just to look at the external, this is Greek. We are coming to Hanukkah. We are just near Hanukkah on the 25th of the month of Kislev. You see, this is out of the past. So Hashem says, we have to be aware of this. We have to do something about it. And then what is Peah? Peah in numerical value, Peh is 80, Aleph is 1, He is 5, together it's 86. 86 is the name of Hashem of judgment. So if I wear a peah, I have judgments upon myself. The name of Hashem Elohim. Elohim is 86. Dear ladies, the name of Hashem of judgment. So let's continue. So it says, dear ladies, I'm giving you, I have to give you. I was with a fight with myself. But after I read this, Rabbi Chaim Vital, I didn't finish the story. Rabbi Chaim Vital did not want to come to that because he said they won't listen to him. But what did he tell him, the soul? He said, you have to, Hashem knows that they don't want to listen to you, but you have to give it because only then you are going to be clean of this. You have to tell. So I hope what comes from my heart will go into the hearts of all the Jewish women. Because it's very important. Because if we will put all of us mitpachad and mitzniut, Mashiach is now here and without judgments. We will go out just like the Jewish people that came out of Egypt. Amen. We will go and Hashem will open the sea for us and we will walk to Israel. Without anybody disturbing us. So this we have to take it to our hearts because I'm giving you now all of the commandments that we go over if we do put a shetel instead of a tichel, which means a wig. We put a wig instead of a mitpachat. It says lifnei ver lo titen michshol vayikra yutet. I put all the places that it was taken from. Before a blind person, do not put an obstacle. So a blind person is a man that walks in the street, and while we walk in the street like this, we are putting an obstacle in front of them. We are the daughters of a king. We should be super. We try to be super modest. Because we are the daughters of a king. We are beautiful. The beauty is from the inside. We are not like the Greeks that looked at Noi. You see, it's the same letters. Like the external beauty. We are the daughters of a king. We need that our soul will have the brightness and the light outside. That everybody would like to be part of Hashem because they see that the daughters of Israel, and we do not emulate the non-Jewish people, the dressing of the non-Jewish people. You know, once all of them, all humanity was very modest. Also the non-Jewish people, they were very modest. The more the evil inclination, the Yetzer Hara, controlled the world, the less clothing they had, more hair we had outside. We'll speak where it started to have a wig. We'll speak about it, but first let's go about the Jewish laws. And the Rambam says, Bilchot Shuva, Bemishne Torah la Rambam, Machtiyeh Arabim, En Lahem Chelek La'olam Haba. He who causes the majority to sin, they don't have part in the true world. Period. Now I know it's hard to take the wig off. I went through it myself. I know it's hard. And when you take upon yourself to raise yourself spirituality, wow, the Yetzer Hara comes from all places. There were even rabbits that came to me and told me, wow, when you wed off your children, you'll go. You have to put a wig. You cannot go with this. You have to put a wig. But I said, no, once I'm accepting this upon myself, this is how I'm going. And I asked from Hashem to give me strength, because it's not easy to give you strength to put the mitpachat, the tichel, all the time. Bezrat Hashem. So, dear ladies, because we cause other people, lifnei velotit en michshol, we cause sin to people who look at us and then have our image in their heads, dear ladies, which, if we go tzniut and we go with the mitpachat, dear ladies, and then they look, we don't have part of their sin. That's their problem. But we have to do our job. We need to do what Hashem wants us to do. And another commandment, lo techalelu et shem kodshi, that you should chas v'shalom, don't cause a damage to my name, because we are representing Hashem's name. We cannot go like the non-Jewish people dress up, because we are representing Hashem. We need to go by the ways of Hashem. And then, v'ayah machanecha kadosh, and all of your camps should be holy. How would we be holy? By being tzniut. Because tzniut is the crown of our husbands, our sons, our children, and the crown of Hashem. And then it said, lo tiyeh acharei rabim lera'ot, which means you should not go after the majority to do evil. So if somebody tell me, but all of us go, and I'll speak about the women that do go, chassidut, that go with a wig. So you'll tell me, but everybody goes, dear ladies. It's a mamash. It's written in the Torah, in Chumash Shmot. Lo tiyeh acharei rabim lera'ot. Do not go after the majority to do evil, even though all of them do. If everybody slanders you, it means that you will slander too? To be accepted in that community? No. If everybody eats treif, will you eat a meat that is not kosher? You won't do it. So it's the same thing, dear ladies. Then it says, I already told you this, because today, and it's written in the book, anybody that wants, I have a few books, I will give it out. I forgot to bring it with me today, but I'll give it you up.
Say it again, the
word. Dear ladies, and it says also, like I told you before, that a lot of the hair come from India, and over there they take it for worshipping idols before they give it out. So just imagine, you put it on your head, and I'll show you over here that a lot of paniot, women that sell even the wigs, they say that truly nobody knows where it comes from. It's all mixed. Dear ladies, it's lot, and on our heads, lot tavi to'ava el beitcha, you bring to'ava, which means evil things, something that is not holy.
Abomination.
Because I wrote this word, abomination, you bring into your home by just putting the wig. And then it's written, Nashim Yekarot, lo yidvak biyadcha me'uma min acherem, that you won't take anything that does not belong to you, and this does not belong, because this is pe'anuchrit. It belongs to the non-Jewish people. You can see it in England, in the courts, they have wigs. You can see it in France, in all of the courts and in all of the kingdom and the kings, pe'anuchrit. You can see it today all, but it's not, yes, but this is not a true minhag of the Jewish women. Where did this minhag come from? Okay, so it says that like 200 years ago, there was the committee of Tunuat Haskala. There was the Committee of Enlightenment, dear ladies. And this Committee of Enlightenment caused everybody to feel that we need to, you know, to become modern, to become more modern, assimilated with the Goyim, with all the non-Jewish people. So they caused people to feel uncomfortable with themselves. This is the Yetzer Hara Mamash. So women started to take off the cover off from the head. Most of them had mitpachat or a hat. Mitpachat or a hat. They used to have, but they started taking it off. Then it says that like 180 years ago in Russia, the Tsar told the women that they are not allowed to go with a cover on their head. So they didn't have any choice, they took off the cover. So some of them made themselves a wig in order to put, and it was a wig like straw. Yes. That's what it was. And then, dear ladies, it says, and I will going to read it to you because so you can, just a minute.
So it started with straw wigs.
Okay. Because they didn't allow, in Russia, they didn't allow to go with a cover on their head. But the Enlightenment Committee, and not how they called movement. The Enlightenment movement caused many people to doubt what they believe in. They caused them to feel like they're very uneducated, very primitive. Mm-hmm. So a lot of the young generation started going after them, and the women took off the cover from their head. I would want to tell you, and it says. It's written in, this is about Chabad, dear ladies. Beigrot HaKodesh, Chelek Zayin Amud Chafdalet. It's written like this. Hamatzav be'Amerika bizmano shel Arabi, the situation in with the women, the Jewish people, the men and the women, in America, in the times of the Rebbe, Shayu Nashim, Sharbe Nashim, Lo Yimechasot Klal Et Rosham. They wouldn't cover their head totally. כמו שמפורש בהרבה מגרות הקודש, like it's written in a lot of the מגרות הקודש. It's written שהיה ממש מדבר רוחני, like a desert of spirituality, because a lot of them did not cover their head. ובאותם הימים, אנשים הצעירות לא כיסו את ראשם בפאה, ולא זו בלבד, אלא שמעטות כיסו את ראשם לאחר נישואים. Which means only a few. At that days, women did not cover their head, and also only a few covered their head after they got married. פאות חפשו רק נשים מבוגרות, only the old women had these wigs that were like straw wigs, yes, that came from Russia and came, only them they had this. And that's why in that times it was, the Rebbe said, okay, at least they will cover their heads with a wig, but this is not the custom of the Jewish women. Wait. And then it says like this, אמו של חסיד חב"ד, רבי חנניה יוסף אייזנבך, שאלה את הרבי אם לפי מה שמפרסמים עליה ללכת בפאה. The mother of Rabbi Hananiah Yosef Eisenbach asked the Rebbe if, because everyone been spread out that the Rebbe is part of the Hasidiyot, the Hasidish people, they say that you have to go with a pair, with a wig. So this is what was his answer. Ana la Rabbi. The Rebbe said, Chas v'shalom, lo nitkavanti le'ela olchot b'mitpachat. I didn't tell Ella that goes with a tichel, with a mitpachat. Rak le'elu she'esh chashash she'bichlal lo yikasu et harosh. But only the women that you know that they won't cover their head if they'll have to put a mitpachat. V'chen katav Rav Yisachar Dov Klevinzer, שליט מרבני חב"ד, he wrote, ולא רק שהרבי לא אסר מעולם את המטפחת, אלא אדרבה, הרבי בעצם סבר שהמטפחת עדיפה מפאה נוכרית. And he said that the מטפחת, איך?
The kerchief, they say.
Kerchief. Remember, this kerchief is mitpachat. When I say mitpachat, you know it's mitpachat. So the mitpachat is preferable over a wig, he said. This is Torat Nachalat Har Chabad Gilayon Lametet Amud Lamed, dear ladies. Harav Moshe Weber, Zchutot Hagen Aleinu, was one of the big rabbis of Hasidut Chabad in our generations. And he was telling a story of himself. הוא מספר בעצמו, הוא היה בקשר עם כמה חסידי חב"ד שחשבו שדעת הרבי לשלול את ההליכה במטפחת בכל מקרה, that they thought that the Rebbe did not want women to go with a mitpachat, dear ladies. מכיוון שהבינו שאי אפשר לחסות את הראש בשלמות, because they thought that you cannot cover your head totally with a mitpachat, which is not true totally. But this is the Yetzer Hara, you understand? The Yetzer Hara finds excuses why to go with this, with a karet on the head instead of keter on the head. This is the Yetzer Hara. You understand? Yetzer Hara doesn't stop working. He wakes up an hour before we wake up. He doesn't leave us yet, Sarara, dear ladies. So, dear ladies, Achatam Sofer says, this is Rabbi Moshe Sofer, Zchutot Hagan Aleinu. Asar al Aisha legalot et Sarah, afilu Sarachat. He says, no woman should even show one hair of her hair. Even though, by Shulchan Aruch, and I will read it for you now, because there are two things. I'm opening and I'm going to give you to now, dear ladies. It's written like this. Isha nesuya, nesua chayevet al pi adin lechasot et rosha. A married woman committed obligated to cover her hair. Ve'ein lalatzet lirshut harabim kshesara megule. And she knows, and she's not allowed to go outside with her hair uncovered. Shesear be'isha erva. Which means that her hair on a woman is erva. Ve'al pi adin mutar li'isha nesua lilech be'beita begilui rosh. In a house, she can do that if there's no strangers in the house. But in order to educate your children, you should be tzniut also in the house, dear ladies. And I'll want to tell you about rega, ken. Nashim ha'nehagot legalot etzba o shtayim from the hair, misarot roshan klapei pnim, that they can see like two fingers of your hair. En limchot be'adam sheken minhagenu. It's a minhag. So it's not forbidden to two. You know what I mean? Like the hair is shown like two fingers, like this. Shtetzbot. It's not forbidden, but by the Zohar Kadosh, a Zohar Kadosh says it's better that the whole hair will be under the mitpachat. The whole hair. That's what the Zohar Kadosh doesn't say a wig. The hair. That the whole hair will be under the mitpachat. This is what by Shulchan Aruch and by Hazor HaKadosh. The Chatam Sofer says that even one hair should not be out like the Zohar HaKadosh. Asar ubechol zot asar pea. Rabbi Moshe Sofer Zchutot Hagan Aleinu forbid any woman to go with a wig. Vohora lechasot rak bemitpachat. Only with a mitpachat. Mashma shebeofen maasi efshar lechasot bemitpachat et kol ha'sarot. And I have two covers. Usually you take two covers. One covers and another mitpachat that you put upon it, dear ladies. So, dear ladies, also Gaon Tuvia Belevi Shalita says, Shachen da'at ha'rabi etad, the Lubavitch Rebbe, lo'oded et mishu mechasa et roshai mitpachat kasher mechasa karaui, which means to encourage all of the women that put mitpachat on their head. Now, there's not more encouragement in the Lubavitch Rebbe than his wife and his mother. Harabanit Chana did not go with a wig. She was with a hat. Some people say it was a wig underneath. I don't know, from the picture that I saw, it seems like her hair, which is allowed to show two fingers of your hair, dear ladies. So if you look at the pictures, they're all with a hat. His wife, if the Rebbe thought that the best thing is to put a wig, his wife, Chaya Mushka, Zchutat Hagan Aleinu, Rabbanit Chaya Mushka, Zchutat Hagan Aleinu, was supposed to be the first one that will go with a wig. And his mother, of course, because this is what the Rebbe said. But they showed example that the way to go is either mitpachat or a hat. And to put all of the hair inside. The Zohar Kadosh says all of the hair inside. And al pi Shulchan Aruch, you're allowed to put two fingers of the hair to be outside. But the best thing is to cover the whole head. And today there's beautiful mitpachot, dear ladies. But I'll continue. Wait. I know it's a little bit longer today, the lesson, but we have to give all of it. Okay, and from Kfar Chabad in Israel, please listen. Hagaon Harav Mordechai Shmuel Ashkenazi Shalita. I published a letter. Persem Mikhtav Vo Katav. כי פאות ארוכות ופזורות ועל אחת כמה וכמה כשנשויות משיער טבעי שמטרתו להידמות לשיער האישה אסורות. This is from Kfar Chabad in Israel. He says, הגאון הרב מרדכי שמואל אשכנזי שליטה פרסם מכתב והוא כתב כי פאות ארוכות, the long wigs, and the ones you know that are fluffy and, ועל אחת כמה, the ones that are from natural hair, על אחת כמה וכמה, that all of the purpose is that it will be like their own hair are forbidden, dear ladies. I would like to tell you something that happened to me, dear ladies. איפה זה לסט רגע? I will have something to add, that I have a student that didn't feel well. That didn't feel well, dear ladies. If she doesn't feel well, she's very sick. So I have her for a few years. She has the disease. One of my students called me and we are diving in for her and blessing her. And I told her, you know what? Please tell her that she should put a cover on her head. The other student was telling me that Rabbanit, she has a wig. I was shocked. I was shocked. I know, I didn't know she has a wig because it doesn't look like a wig. Totally, I was sure it was her own hair. Yes. I didn't even have a question mark. I was 100% sure it was her own hair. I'll give you another example. I was walking in BJ. It was like a year and a half ago. And in front of me, towards me came a woman I saw with a child. She was blonde. And when I saw her from far away, I thought, I didn't think it was a Jewish woman. But when she came close to me, I said, wow, this is a daughter of a rabbi that I know. I wouldn't have known that she was Jewish. I wouldn't have thought that she was Jewish. So if I see that as a woman, על אחת כמה וכמה what the men see. And I'm a woman.
I had a wig, I went to Yeshua. And Rabbi said, cover your head. I said, this is a wig. It's a cover your head.
So I want to tell you now, I have a few things to give you. Wait, we didn't finish. I have a few things. Okay. Who are the poskim that are not allowed? I'm going to give you out of 100 poskim, a few of them. Who are the poskim that do not allow to wear a wig, and it doesn't matter if it's a synthetic wig or a regular wig from human hair. So this is part of the Rashima. Hagaon Rabbi Binyamin Musaifa Bal Musaf Aruch, Zchutot Hagan Elenu. Hagaon Rabbi Yechezkel Mintz Katzal Weigen, I hope I'm pronouncing the name. קצל נלבוגן, בעל הדרשות מרבי מינץ, זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יששכר בר איינגלבורג, בעל שאלות ותשובות באר שבע, זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי אליהו מווילנה, הגאון מווילנה, הגרה, dear ladies, forbid wigs. הגאון רבי יעקב עמדין, היבץ, dear ladies, בעל שאלת היבץ. הגאון רבי, זכותו תגן אלינו, הגאון רבי שלמה קלוגר, בעל שנות חיים, זכותו תגן אלינו, הגאון רבי חיים בן בן אשתי, בעל כנסת הגדולה, זכותו תגן אלינו, הגאון רבי יוסף תאומים, בעל פרי מגדים, זכותו תגן אלינו, הגאון רבי חיים יוסף דוד אזולאי, יחידה, זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי משה סופר בעל חתם סופר, זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יאיר בקרח בעל חוות יאיר, זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי מנחם מנדל הצמח צדק מלובביץ', עליו השלום, זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי פנחס הלוי הורוביץ', בעל הפליאה, זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי חיים מצ'אנס, בעל שאלות תשובות דברי חיים, זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי אלעזר פלקלס, בעל תשובה מאהבה, I hope that I'm pronouncing right the names, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יעקב משולם אורנשטיין, בעל ישועות יעקב, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יהודה אסעד, בעל שאלות תשובות יהודה יעלה, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי משולם זלמן כהן, אב בית דין פיורדה, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי וולף המבורג, בעל שר זקנים, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי אברהם פלאג'י, בעל ברכת אברהם, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי אברהם תאומים, בעל שאלות ותשובות חסד לאברהם, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי שלום מרדכי הכהן, בעל שאלות ותשובות
מהרשם עליו של זכות תגנו, תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יצחק אבולעפיה בעל פני יצחק עלו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יחיאל הלברשטיין בעל דברי יחזקאל עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי שלמה יהודה מסיגט בעל תשורת שי עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יששכר דוב גרוקח האדמור מבלז עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי צבי היר שפירה בעל דרכי תשובה עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי ישעיהו ברלין בעל יש סדר למשנה עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי ישראל ליפשיץ בעל תפארת ישראל עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. ברוך אתה אדוני אלמלך המשה קוני המדבור.
אמן.
יצרה לא רוצה שאני אתן. אוקיי, הגאון רבי חיים אלעזר שפירה, בעל מנוחת אליעזר, זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יוסף צבי דושנסקי, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יהושע לייב דיסקין, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי שמואל סלנט, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יצחק אייזיק מספינקה, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי שלמה אליעזר אלפנדרי, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי עקיבא שלזינגר, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יקותיאל יהודה טיטלבאום, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי צבי הירש חיות בעל שאלות ותשובות מארץ חיות, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי הלל ליכטנשטיין בעל אבקת רוחל, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי אברהם חיים איינהיירן בעל שערי תואר, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יואל טיטלבאום מסאטמר, עליו תקשיב, all of these are the ones that forbid טיטלבאום, עליו השלום זכותו תגן עלינו. all of these forbid wigs. הגאון רבי מצליח מזוז, הגאון רבי אברהם יצחק הכהן קוק, הגאון רבי יעקב מוצפי, הגאון רבי אהרון רטה בעל שומר אמונים, הגאון רבי מרדכי שרבי זקן המקובלים, עליו עליהם השלום זכותם תגן עלינו. הגאון רבי יהודה צדקה בראש ישיבת פורת יוסף. הגאון רבי חיים חזקיהו מדיני בעל שדי חמד. הגאון רבי יוסף חיים זוננפלד רבי ירושלים. הגאון רבי ישראל חברו חצר הבבא סאלי. הגאון רבי יקותיאל יהודה הלברשטיין מקליבזנבורג קלוזנברג, עליו השלום. I said already מחילה that sometimes I don't pronounce it as it is. הגאון רבי אריה פריינד בעל עטרת יהושע. הגאון רבי שלמה זלמן אוירבך בעל שאלות תשובות מנחת שלמה. הגאון רבי משה לוי בעל שאלות תשובות תפילה למשה. הגאון מרן רבי עובדיה יוסף בעל שאלות ותשובות יביע עומר. וגאוני דורנו הרב הגאון רבי שמואל הלוי וזנר, הגאון רבי שמואל אוירבך, הגאון רבי אברהם דוד הורוביץ, הגאון רבי בן ציון מוצפי, הגאון רבי יצחק ברדה, הגאון רבי מאיר מזוז, הגאון רבי יצחק רצבי, הגאון הראשון לציון רבי יצחק יוסף. And there's a lot in the lists. I would like to give you another thing about Hasidus. רק רגע, just a minute, I just need to find it because it's a...
How did you get so crazy?
Because the Yetzer Hara works on us. We all want to look beautiful, so we persuade ourselves to go with the wigs. Even though if you'll be true with yourself, you know it's not the right way. If you just sit with yourself, you know it's not right. It's not tzniut.
Well, how come the synthetic
wigs? Just a minute, רק תביא לי ל... And I want you to know that Admor HaZaken, Baal HaTanya, his wife, Eshet Admor HaZaken, Zechuto Tagen Aleinu, Halcha Bemitpachat. She went with a mitpachat, with a tichel. Ve'eshet Admor HaEmtzei, Halcha Bemitpachat. And the Admor HaEmtzei was also with a mitpachat. Ve'eshet Admor HaTzemach Tzedek went with a tichel. Ve'eshet Admor Maharash went with a tichel. Nimtza Sherov Admorei Chabad Lavshu Neshotem Mitpachat. And we know that the Rebbe's wife, Chaya Mushka, was also, she went with a hat. And we know that his mother went with a hat. The Rebbe Tzinchana, she went with a hat. So this is the example.
Dear ladies, this is example. I would like to give you a few more things. Dear ladies, a few more things. It says the Rabbi Ben Zion Mutzafi was asked if the pair, if the wig is tzniut, even if a wig is short. Even if it's short, it's not tzniut. I'm giving you what I'm telling you. This is all from the books of Torah. This is what I'm giving you. I know. The big question is, why does the Yetzer Hara take the rabbitsons, the big rabbitsons? Because if he takes one rabbitson and she puts a wig, then the whole community will be with a wig. So
not just rabbitson. I know that, let's say my daughter, she's going to Yeshiva University. They absorb all the laws. And the rabbis there allow a certain degree.
Dear ladies, again, please listen. Please listen. When we are standing there in front of Hashem in the true world, it won't help by saying that everybody went with it. And that the rabbis, some of the rabbis say you can go with it. They will be punished, but they will be punished, but we will be punished too. I was with a wig too. I want you to understand this. You cannot tell them this because this is Shulchan Aruch. I'm giving. It's not that I wake up in the morning and I decided to give you something that just went into my head. No. I also searched for it when I took off the wig and put that mitpachat, the tichel. I also looked for it. I know that also the Ashkenazi women and all the Sephardic and the Yemen, they did not go with it. I just showed you. You can fight with this. Simcha, you cannot fight with this. This is the truth. This is the truth. I know it bothers because now the Yetzer Hara is fighting. We have a big fight among ourselves. So what? Yes, because now I'm giving you the truth. This is what you need to know about the wig. You have to know about it. So let's summarize it. Let's do a summarize. Wait, where is my Ken? Let's do a. I don't know where I put my. You see, just a minute. Oh, Ine, thank you, Hashem. Okay. So. Let's look at mitpachat Yehudit, mitpachat techel, and let's look at peah, at a wig. And just put one, I wanted to write it on the board.
Compare?
Yeah, just to compare it. So, if we take a mitpachat, this is a legitimate, a glat kosher kisui rosh, cover of the head. Why? Because this comes a keter. This is glat kosher. It says v'shulchan aruch, Shulchan aruch is accepted by everybody. If we take a wig, more than 100 poskim say that these wigs of our generation are not considered kisui rosh because they are just like a regular hair, and they even say even the synthetic ones of today are just like, it's not the ones that were once like a straw. This is mamash hair, looks like hair. So more than 100 poskim. And you have the merit to listen to it. So Hashem didn't bring you lechinam to listen to it. Hashem has a plan. It says, Ein b'mitpachat achtat arabim. We do not cause the majority to sin if we have a tichel, if we have mitpachat. But aloveshet pe'ah machtia et arabim b'riyah v'b'irurei avera. But she who has a wig causes the majority to sin by looking at the hair, at her hair, and also by having thoughts about her hair, I don't know, the beauty. Mitpachat, ein shum chashash shel avodah zara. You're not afraid that there will be worshipping idols. But chashash mamashi shel anah mitkorvet avodah zara yesh bepeah, which means when you wear a wig, there's already a concern that you are holding on yourself tikovet avodah zara, idol, hair that was put for idolship. Again, we go back to the tichel. Goremet lelovesht ota leraot ki imotenu shebechol adorot. She who has a tichel, a mitpachat, v'sha'a tova, looks like all of our foremothers. Sarah, Rivka, Rachel, v'Leah, and all of our foremothers in the past. She who has a wig, goremet la loveshet ota leraot keachat agoyot. She who wears a wig looks like one of the non-Jewish people. Because it's called Peanochrit. It's not our, we did not invent it, dear ladies. Simcha, I'm giving, I know, I told you at the beginning, I don't know how many students I'll have at the end of the lesson. I told you. But I love you. I love all of you. I'm doing this because I love you, because I know that there won't be any excuses. And because I want to bring Mashiach, and we can be, we are us women, leave the job for the men. We can do it. We can bring Mashiach just by forcing the Yetzer Hara. And it's not easy, I know, because I had a week too, so I come from that place. I can tell you how it's hard. But I had the first step. אבל את ראית אותי, מדלן, you saw me, מדלן, את יודעת איזה כיסוי ראש יפי, מלכה, the daughter of a king.
מדלן.
Wait, please let me finish and then we'll have questions, wait. כן. And then, she was a mitpachat, a mitpachat or a kova, I mean, when I say mitpachat, a tichel, I mean also a hat. She was a hat or mitpachat, goremet kiddush Hashem gadol b'nei rechokim mitorah u'mitzvot, causes a big kiddush Hashem, praises the name of Hashem in the eyes of the ones that are not observant. Goremet, and the one that goes with the wig, goremet chilul Hashem gadol b'nei rechokim mitorah u'mitzvot, that which means the ones that are not observant and they see her with the wig. You heard that woman that is testifying about herself, what happened to her, it was in Yerushalayim. You heard what she says. And there are a lot of stories about it. So this is chad mashmei. It's black and white. It's just we need to fight the evil inclination, the Yetzer Hara, and then you know what kind of zchut this is, the kind of merit it is to conquer it? And a woman that goes with a mitpachat or a hat. Isha loveshet ota nir'et nesua merchika mimena zarim. She who puts it on her, she, you know that she's married and she pushes away from her men.
And what about those
that are the ones that have a wig? Some of the wigs, you don't even know it's a wig. I'm telling you, you look and you don't know that it's a wig. Causes people, you know, there's a story over here, I have to tell you. There were two chassidim. This is a story about a wedding in Yerushalayim. Two chassidim, friends, dear ladies. They didn't meet each other for a long time. One came from abroad to Israel to come to the wedding, and the other one didn't know his wife. And they were at the wedding, you know, separated, the men over here, the woman over there. So his friend said, you know, I want to get married. He said, you know what, it's a wedding. Maybe just take a glance and maybe you'll find somebody that you like. And you won't believe what happened. He took a glance and he says, you know, there's a woman over there with long straight hair. This is the woman that I want. So his friend that is married looks, he says, this is my wife.
Wow.
This is my wife. So dear ladies, it's an honest, because sometimes you don't even know it's a wig. So it's an honest thing that you get mistaken. Let's continue. The woman that wears a mitpachat or a hat, מעוררת רחמים גדולים על הלובשת אותה ועל כלל ישראל. Causes a lot of mercy from Hashem upon her and Klal Yisrael. And a woman that wears a wig, מעוררת דינים על הלובשת אותה ועל כלל ישראל. Causes judgment upon herself and upon Klal Yisrael. And this is Peah in Hebrew, you saw, it's the name of Hashem of judgment. Let's continue. Dear women, the woman that wears a mitpachat or a hat, there's no problem to pray against her. You know what I mean? Kenegda. But there are some poskim that say that there's a problem to pray against a woman that has a pe'ah, because it's like a hon hair. Se'ar be'isha yirva. It's like, it seems like it's her own hair. It's like you're giving a blessing in vain. יש פוסקים שסוברים שכל ברכה שמברכים לידה ליד מישהי שחובשת פאה היא לבטלה. מטפחת, עוד פעם, go back to the מטפחת, גורמת ללובשת אותה רגש ענווה ורצון להדר בצניעות. She who has a מטפחת, or a hat, causes, regains like the characteristic of modest, it's not modesty, it's humbleness.
Humility.
Humility, exactly, of humility, and this helps her to be more tzniut. And the women that wear wigs, the wig causes sometimes pride,
arrogance.
The arrogance. And you have to be, we have to be true to ourselves too. Gaava. Goremet gaava. גורמת הלבשות הרגש גאווה ודרדור בצניעות. גדולי הפוסקים מכנים, the big פוסקים, the biggest פוסקים, and it includes the בן איש חי, includes everybody. Dear ladies, the biggest פוסקים say that the woman that goes with מטפחת or hat, מכנים אותה בכינויים מחמיאים ומעודדים. They encourage her, they say she is the crown of the children of Israel. And the woman that go with a sheitel, peah, with a wig, gdolei haposkim mechanim ota bekinuyei gnai ma'alivim. All the poskim that do not forbid it, and there are a lot of poskim, we just don't know it, because it's an industry of money. Mm-hmm. I have to tell you, this is the yetzer hara, the industry of money. You cannot compare the money that you pay for a wig for the money that you pay, $20, $35 for a mitpachat. You cannot, there's
thousand
no, yes, you cannot compare it. So the evil in today, the idleness in this world is money. So it's an industry of money, dear ladies. Then, dear ladies, another thing, like Kimchit had seven righteous high priests, because she covered her hair, and even the walls of her house did not see her hair. And Tamar, the daughter-in-law of Yehuda, because she covered her hair, dear ladies, Hashem gave her as a present at Mashiach ben David, at King David. And from her comes Mashiach ben David. And look at Rivka. Rivka, when she saw Yitzchak, she covered her hair. She wasn't married yet. She covered her hair and she received from Hashem et Yaakov Avinu, and from him the 12 tribes. So a woman that covers her hair with a hat or with a mitpachat, goremet shebaneh yu chachamim v'chashuvim v'yirei Hashem, that the children will be righteous and will be very wise. Hashem gives them a lot of wisdom. And even if they didn't do tshuva yet, they will do tshuva yet because of the zchut of the mitzvah. And then, dear ladies, the poskim say that a woman, more than 100 poskim say that a woman that wears a wig causes her children less spirituality. So, dear women, I gave you everything from the books. It's not me that I'm giving you. This is what Hashem gave me. This is a chidush. But everything that I gave you is from the Torah itself. It's from the Shulchan Aruch. It's from Mishneh Torah LaRambam. It's from the Ben Ish Chai. It's from even the Lubavitcher Rebbe. I gave you from Igrot HaKodesh. It's from the Bereshit Rabba. It's from Rabbi Chaim Vital, Sefer HaChezionot. It's everything. But that's why I schlepped today a lot of books. I couldn't bring all the books that I want, but at least these that you can see. It's from the Yalkut Yosef Shel Rav Avadia Yosef. Dear ladies, I know it's not easy, but we need to sit with ourselves and like do soul searching and write to ourselves and be true to ourselves, and then we connect to Hashem totally. Absolutely. Accepting to go with a tichel, a mitpachat, or a hat is very hard for a woman that goes with a wig. I know, I went with a wig. It's not easy. But I sat with myself and did a soul searching, and I understood that what Hashem says, this is the truth. This is really what I need to do. And I took off the wig and I put the tichel, the mitpachat. So, dear ladies,
your children,
amen. And Hashem, because of that, blessed me and blesses Klal Yisrael, because like I told you, the poskim say that you're not only protecting your children and yourself, you're protecting Klal Yisrael. And the women of Israel, that when the Israelites that went out of Egypt, they didn't have a wig, dear ladies. They were all with mitpachat, with a tichel. Yeah. And they were very righteous because of their merit we went out of Egypt. So if we work on ourselves, on the tzniut, on our tzniut, the way we dress up, dear ladies, the way we cover our head, and I know it's step by step, If we work on self, then b'siyata d'shmaya, we can bring Mashiach without any judgment. And dear ladies, I would like to tell you that I love all of you. Don't get chas v'chalila the wrong impression. I'm just giving you from the poskim everything, so you will know, because otherwise Hashem will come and tell me, why didn't you tell my daughters? You had to tell them. I have to give it to you. Dear ladies, because sometimes the tichel moves a little bit, so you put something underneath, it stands in its place, doesn't move. So dear ladies, I would like to bless all of us b'siyata d'shmaya, שהגיע משיח צדקנו במהרה בימינו, אמן. אליהו נביא זכור לטוב, לעולם מפרד אדם מחברו בדבר הלכה, יחיד ברבים, הלכה כרבים. Hashem bless you.